What's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venture Visualist, and today I'm really hyped up to be showing you guys a breakdown of this Dreamy Haze filter effect that's been really popular recently in a lot of music video edits, creative edits, and more. So if you're a video editor and you've been on social media at all in the past couple weeks or months, you've seen this ad getting run by this company called creativeassets.ca. It's a really dope looking ad, and they're basically advertising this Dreamy Haze filter effect that you can download and apply to your clips. So I went ahead and downloaded it and paid $20 for it. So in this video, I'm gonna be talking a little bit about whether or not I think the effect itself was worth the $20. And I'm also gonna be breaking down the effect so that you guys can actually make this effect from scratch and not pay any money for it if you don't want to. So without further ado, let's hop into Adobe Premiere Pro. So here in Adobe Premiere Pro, I have a music video pulled up that I shot last year with Luck the Artist. The song is called Bad Habits. So I'm basically just going to recreate the effect that these guys are selling as a preset from scratch. Now, I'm definitely not trying to take away from their sales by making this video. I'm just trying to break down how they made this effect. I thought this effect would look good on this clip right here because he's in a hotel. We got that blue lighting, that nice blue lighting. Step one is to just duplicate whatever clip you're trying to make this effect happen on. So I'm just gonna go ahead and duplicate it like that, stack it on top of each other. I'm gonna select this top clip that we just made, and I'm gonna change the blend mode from normal to screen, and I'm gonna turn it down to about 80. The next thing I'm gonna do is apply a luma key. So I'm just gonna drag my luma key over onto my top clip like this, and you'll see that we have a threshold of 100 and a cutoff of 0 automatically. Now if I change this cutoff, you can kind of see we get a little bit more contrast the higher I go up, and a little bit less contrast the lower I take it down. That's cool, we'll revisit that effect. The next step you wanna do is apply a Gaussian blur. Now this is one of my favorite effects in Adobe Premiere Pro. It's one of the ones I use the most, and we're just gonna set it right on top of this clip. You're gonna check this box that says repeat edge pixels, and we're gonna turn this up to 500. So now we kinda get this glow effect happening. This is all this effect is a Gaussian blur, a luma key, and your blend mode change. That's all it was when I downloaded it. From here, I was able to basically play around with my cutoff, and you can make the glow a little bit more or a little bit less. It looks a little bit nicer now that we have the Gaussian blur set on it. But let's go ahead and take a look at what this clip looked like before this effect, and then let's take a look at what it looks like after this effect is applied. Never knew that we would take it far. If you ain't know my nigga, I ain't fun to play with y'all. A young nigga from the west side, never had it. These niggas faking, it's no wonder they be in dramatic bad habits. Never knew that we would take it far. If you ain't know my nigga, I ain't fun to play with y'all. A young nigga from the west side, never had it. These niggas faking, it's no wonder they be in dramatic bad habits. Never knew that we would take it far. If you ain't know my nigga, I ain't fun to play with y'all. A young nigga from the west side, never had it. These niggas faking, it's no wonder they be in dramatic bad habits. Because it was a new concept that I'll probably use in the future on future edits, you know, I think it was worth the $20. But I really think it is easy to recreate on your own and just make it from scratch. So I think I probably would have paid more, so between $5 and $10 for something like this. On a side note, if any of you video editors out there are interested in downloading some visual assets for your own projects, check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I have some really cool overlays and transitions on there that are really helpful for creative edits. And don't forget to subscribe and like this video if you enjoyed it. I'm really trying to stay consistent with these tutorials and sharing my knowledge and just exploring what else is out there in the video editing space. Once again, guys, thanks for tuning in. I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.